Hey guys, hi, welcome back. So in this video, we will discuss the questions of chest examination, which was held on 25 July. And I hope that all have done well. So we will start with the first question here. So the first question here is, consider a system consisting of three non-degenerate energy levels with energy 0 epsilon and 2 epsilon. In the limit of infinite temperature, T tends to infinity, the probability of finding a particle in the ground state is. So here you are asked to find the probability of finding a particle in the ground state. And you are having three non-degenerate energy levels. And the energies are given to you 0 epsilon, 2 epsilon. Okay. And you will have to find the probability of the particle to be in the ground state at temperature T tends to infinity. Clear? So for this, we will use the probability for the ith state. Okay. So we know this is a direct formula based question. So we know the probability. Okay. For ith state. For ith state, it is written as P. It is equals to e to the power minus beta epsilon. Okay. I divided by Z. Z is the partition function. And it is denoted by epsilon I e to the power minus beta epsilon I. All right. So this is the probability for the ith state. Now you're asked for the ground state. That means probability for E naught. Okay. That is what? Probability for this energy. Okay. So this is will be for the ith state. This is the energy for the ground state here. So it will be what? E to the power minus beta 0. Right? Because the energy for the ground state is given to you 0. Next, you see here, partition function will be the sum of these three terms. So it will be what? E to the power minus beta 0 plus e to the power minus beta. Here it is epsilon plus e to the power minus beta 2 epsilon, right? So if you see here, this will give you what? 1. Here also you will get 1, okay? Plus e to the power beta is what? 1 by kt. So it is epsilon by kt plus e to the power minus 2 epsilon by kt. Just putting the value of beta. Now you see here, here say T tends to infinity. If T tends to infinity, you will get what? In this case, if T tends to infinity, that means you will get what? Something divided by infinity, right? That means you will get e to the power 0, which means this term will be also 1, this term will be also 1. When you will put the condition, T tends to infinity in the denominator. And finally, you will get the probability of the particle to be in the ground state. It will be what? 1 by 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 1 by 3. Clear? So the correct option is option C. So this was a formula-based question. You just need to know the correct formula. Now let's see the next question. Here it is said, if L is the angular momentum operator in quantum mechanics, the value of L cross L will be what? So you will have to find this value in quantum mechanics. So if you are very good in the memory power, then I can say that you can directly put the answer to be the option B, okay, which is the correct option. And if you are having confusion, then you can just do the cross product. Okay, so you know L is equals to what? Lx I cap plus Ly j cap plus Lz k cap, right? This is what you can do. So now you have to find L cross L. So this is I cap, j cap, k cap, I cap. Okay, so this is Lx, Ly, Lz, Lx. Again, Lx, Ly, Lz, Lx. So to find L cross L, okay, what you will do? This is I cap. You will get what? Yz, Ly, Lz minus Lz, Ly plus J cap. Then you will get what? Zx, okay, Lz, Lx minus Lx, Lz plus K cap. For K cap, you will have what? Lx, Ly minus Ly, Lx. So if you see this, this is the combination of what? Ly, Lz. This is the commutation of what? This is the commutation of Lz and Lx. Yes or no? This is the commutation of what? Lx and Y. Right. This is what it is. So when you will write it to be, you will write it to be I h cut will be outside, because in quantum mechanics, this will be equals to what? I h cut L. It will be what? It will be Yz, so it will be Lx, right? It is Zx, so it will be what? Ly. And the last one will be what? Lz. Okay. So if you see here, this will be what? Lx I cap plus Ly j cap plus Lz k kk. And this term is representing what? L. So you will get I h cut L. So you got L cross L is what? I h cut L. Clear? So this was very easy. Even if you don't remember, you can just do it in few seconds. So now let's see question number 3. Which one of the following sets represent correctly the Hamilton's equation of motion from the Lagrangian L equals to half m x dot pi dot minus half m omega square x y? So you are having 4 options. You will have to choose one option which is representing correctly the Hamilton's equation of motion for the Lagrangian given. Okay, so how you will write the Hamiltonian? We know h is equals to what? Summation p dot qk dot minus L. Okay, so from here you can write the Hamilton will be equals to what? So here you are having what? X and y, right? So you will have px x dot, right? Plus py y dot, because it's the summation of what? The coordinates. And here you will have what? Minus L. L is half m x dot y dot plus half m omega square x y. So this is the Hamiltonian. Now what you will have to do? You will have to replace this x dot from this, because it is what? Hamiltonian, it is the function of only the momentum coordinate, right? You will have to remove this x dot. So for this, what you will write? We know, what we know? You know that px is equals to what? Del L, del x dot. And py is equals to what? Del L, del y dot. So when you will do px is equals to del L del x dot means what? You will get half m y dot, right? And you will get p y is equals to what? Half m x dot. So from here, if you see from this entire term, what you will get? You will get m y dot is equals to what? 2 p x. And from here, what you will get? M y x dot, it is equals to what? 2 p y. So from the option also, you see m x dot is what? 2 p y. M y dot is what? 2 p x. Okay, so from here, if you see out of option A and B, one will be the answer because we have done half. Okay, now we will put these values and we will write the Hamiltonian h. So h will be equals to what? This is px x dot. So px x dot is equals to what? It is x dot will be equals to, it will be 2 py by m, right? And here you will write p y. Y dot is equals to what? 2 px by m. All right. Minus half m is as it is, x dot will be what? 2 p y by m. This is 2 p x by m. The last term will be as it is, half m omega square x y. Okay. So from here, if you see h will be equals to what? This will give you what? 2 p x p y by m. Okay. Plus 2 p x p y by m. Here this 2 and 2 will get cancelled, m and m will get cancelled, and you will have what? Minus 2 px py by m plus half m omega square xy. These two terms will get cancelled because these are same terms, and finally you will get h is equals to what? Let me write in this next page. You will get h is equals to 2 px py by m plus half m omega square xy. Okay, now we will see the other equations. Okay, so we know what? Hamilton's equation is what? You know, pk dot, you can write it equals to what? Minus del h del qk dot. Okay. And qk dot, it is equals to what? Del h del pk. So from here, what we will write first? We will write px dot, because we have already found what is mx dot. We will go for px dot. So it is what? Minus del h del x, right? And py dot, it is equals to what? Minus del h del y, right? So when you will do px dot will be equals to what? Minus del h del x. That means it will give you what? Half m omega square y. And py dot, it is equals to what? Minus half m omega square x. Right? So you can see the option. It is minus half m omega square x minus half omega square y. Because here it is pop. What is that wrong? This is px dot is what? Half m omega square x, but it should be y. So your correct option is option A. This was just based on the Hamilton's equation, and you will have to just find the Hamiltonian. Okay, from Lagrangian you will get what? M y dot and m x dot, and to find p x dot and p y dot, you will have to find the Hamiltonian. Clear? Very easy question. Now let's see the next question. So here it is said, a one-dimensional box contains three identical particles. okay, you are having a one-dimensional box and it is having three identical particles in the ground state of the system. Find the ratio of the total energies of the particles if they were spin half particles to that if they were bosons. So here the question says you have a one-dimensional box, okay, which is containing three identical particles, okay, in the ground state of the system. In the ground state, it is having three identical particles. You are asked to find the ratio of the total energies of the particle if the particles were what? Fermions or bosons. So when you are talking about fermions, you will see first here the spin is given to you, half. So the degeneracy is equal to what? 2s plus 1, right? And it will be what? 2 into half plus 1. That means degeneracy is 2. That means one spin can have 2 particles, right? And for bosons, all the 3 particles can be in the same state. If you have studied about bosons and fermions, I don't think this concept is very complicated. You guys know. So this is fermions and this is bosons. All right. So it is stating, if you are having what? This is for n is equals to 1. This is for n is equals to 2. Okay. Fermions, 2 particles can be in one state and one will be here. For bosons, if you see, this is n is equals to 1. This is n is equals to 2. So here, all the 3 particles can be in this particular state. Okay. Okay, this is representing E2, this is E1. This is what? E1, this is E2. Now you see, the question is talking about a one-dimensional box. So for one-dimensional box, we know the energy E is equal to what? N square pi square h cut square by 2ma square, right? So for this, if you see, the total energy E will be equal to what? 2E1, since 2 particles are there, plus E2, right? So 2E1. E1 means what? N will be equals to 1. So you will get it to be equals to what? Pi square h cut square by 2ma square plus this will give you what? 4, right? Pi square h cut square by 2ma square. Finally, this will give you what? 6 by 2 pi square h cut square by ma square. Similarly, if you are talking about bosons, then you can write total energy E is equals to what? 3E1, right? So that is 3. And this will be what? Pi square h cut square by 2ma square. Now you are asked to find the ratio. Okay. Ratio of what? Energy. This is for fermions. This is for bosons. That is total energies of the particle. If they were fermions to that, if they were bosons. EF by EB. All right. So when you will do so, you will see what? Fermions is what? 6 by 2. Okay. Pi square h cut square by ma square into which this is what? 2ma square by 3 pi square h cut square, right? So if you see here, this part will get cancelled. 3, 2s are, this 2ma square, 2ma square get cancelled and you will have only what? 2. Okay? That means, what is the ratio? The ratio is 2. So the correct option is option C. Clear? Now let's see the next question. So here it is said, a particle of mass m. Okay, this is a particle of mass m having a non-zero angular momentum of magnitude L is subject to a central force potential Vr. Okay, that is equals to K ln R, where K is a constant and R is equals to what? Mod of R. What is the radius of R at which it will have a circular orbit? Will the orbit be stable or unstable? So the question is very obvious. It is a central force potential question. You will have to just find whether it is circular orbit. Okay, it will have a circular, whether it is stable or unstable. So for this, we know when we are talking about what? Central force, we are writing V effective first. V effective is equals to what? Vr, right? Plus L square by 2mr square. Okay, this is due to the central force field. This term comes, right? So we already know, we have seen that if you will have the value of what? Del square V, del x square or whatever it is, okay, that is the double derivative, second derivative, that is V double prime effective. If it is what? Greater than zero, then it's stable. Less than zero, then it is unstable, right? So for this, first we will find V prime effective. It is equals to what? Zero, okay? First derivative must be equals to zero. And this VE is equals to what? This is what? K ln R, right? So when you will do so, you see L square by 2m, it is constant. Right, and here you will get what? Minus 2 by r to the power 3 plus k ln r, that is k by r. This is equals to 0. So finally, this 2 will get cancelled with this 2 and you will have here what? Minus l square by m r cube plus k by r equals to 0. And from here, what you will get? you will have L square by M R cube, it is equals to K by R. Okay, that means you will have here what? R square is equals to what? L square by M K, right? And R is equals to what? L by root over M K. This I am writing R is equals to R naught. Okay, so this is the value of R, L by root over M K. Okay, so you will see these two options, C and D, is having the value of R to be this. Now you will have to check whether it is stable or unstable, right? So you got R to be equals to what? L by root over M K. So you will find V double prime effective. So V prime effective, once you got minus, you got what? It was L square by M R cube plus K by R, right? This was what you got. Now when you will take the derivative once again, okay, at what? R is equals to capital R, okay? Then it will be equals to what? It will be 3 L square by M R to the power 4. Just differentiate minus K by R square, all right? So this is the value of what? R, okay? And R square is equals to what? L square by M K. So if you see here, this will give you what? 3 L square by M, and this is what? M square K square by L to the power 4 minus, again you will have what? This is reverse you will have to take, right? It is K M K by L square. So if you see here, this is what? 1 M will get cancelled with 1 M. You will have what? 3 M K square by what? L square. This is minus M K square by L square. And finally, you will have what? 2 M K square by L square. Right? This is V prime. You see, this is positive, right? That is greater than 0. So it is a what? Stable orbit. Okay? And the value of R is what? L by root over M K. Clear? So the correct option is option D. Done. Now let's see the next question. So here what it is said, a solid sphere and a solid cylinder, both of uniform mass density, start rolling down without slipping from rest from the same height along an inclined plane shown in the figure. Which one of the following statement is correct? So you're having a solid sphere and a cylinder. Okay, they are having uniform mass density and they are rolling without slipping. That means it's a pure rolling case. Okay, from rest, and it is rolling from where? From the same height along what? An inclined plane. So you will have to say which one statement is correct, whether the sphere will reach the bottom first, or the cylinder, or the one which is heavier and having both the ready to be identical, or both the objects will reach at the same time if they are ready is identical. Okay, so if you see here in this case, you are having what? Suppose of something of this type, okay, right? So in this way, whether it's a sphere or it's a cylinder, you will see the object from the side view in this way only, right? So if you take this way, in this case, this part will what? This object will rotate, right? It will roll, yes or no? When it will roll, you will see the center will what? Accelerate. Yes or no? Center will accelerate and this point will act as a pivot, you can see. Okay? So for this, we will use the what? Center equation. This will be what? Mg. Okay? And here, the acceleration center of mass, it will be equals to what? Alpha R. You can write in this way. And when you will do this, angle is theta. And if you will what? Evaluate, you will get it to be equals to what? Torque, you can find. From here, it will be mg sine theta. If you will see here, when you will do this angle is what? Theta. Okay, when this angle is theta, and you, when you will take, this will give you what? This is mg cos theta, this is mg sine theta. Okay, and the cos theta term will cancel, and you will have only mg sine theta. So for this, you will just use the torque equation to solve. We will do it. You can do it from the other way also, but we will use the torque equation about the point O. About the point O means the point O, this point. Okay, this point. I'm considering it to be O. So talk about O. Talk about O. And if you're having any problem, then you can just go and see the torque equation. Okay. So talk about O is what? It is I alpha. And this I is about that particular point only. So I'm writing it to be I O only. Okay. This is I O. Now you see, in this case, what you will write? This term I O. Torque is equals to what? Mg sine theta equals to what? this is mg sin theta, I naught will be equals to what? It will be obviously equals to above the center of mass plus mr square, right? This is how you can write. So you will write it to be equals to what? Center of mass plus mr square, and this is what? Alpha. Okay, and we already have seen what it was. We have got ACM, it was equals to what? Alpha r. From here we got alpha is equals to what? ACM by r. When you will put here, this is what? Mg sine theta, it is equals to ICM plus m r square. Okay, this is ACM, this is r is there. Okay, here ICM, and here you will get what? R square it will be. Okay, mg sine theta r was there, so it will be mg sine theta r square. Now from here, if you see, you will get this acceleration, it is equals to what? Mg sine theta r square by ICM plus m r square. Okay, now I'm removing r square, so it will be mg sine theta by what? ICM by r square plus, here you will have m. Yes or no? This is what you will have from this case. If I am bringing this mr square, this is 1. Okay, I am bringing this mr square. Okay, because here also one m is there, na? Just a second. This m also I am removing. Okay, taking out this mr square term. Okay, so I am writing it more clearly here. This is g sine theta will be there in the numerator. In the denominator, you will have what? ICM by mr square plus 1. Now, why I have done so? So that we will see at the end, we will see the dependency on which factor it will depend, that which object will reach the bottom faster. Okay. Now you see here, for this case, it is depending on what? ICM, right? So if you know for case of what? Sphere. For sphere, ICM is equals to what? 2 by 5 mr square. Directly you know. And for cylinder, it is equals to what? It is 1 by 2 mr square. Now, when you will put the value here, in this case, you will get g sine theta will be there as it is. This will give you what? It will have, you will have 2 by 5 plus 1 once, or you will have what? 1 by 2 plus 1, right? This is what you will have. This will give you what? 7 by 2. This will give you what? 3 by 2, right? This is what you will have from this. So when you will see from this, which one is greater? Which one will be greater? That you will have to see. So here if you see 3 by 2 or 7 by 2, obviously 7 by 2 is greater. Yes or no? 7 by 2 is greater. That means what? This was for sphere. Yes or no? So if sphere is giving you what? The greater one, that means the sphere will reach what? The bottom faster. Yes or no? Because if you see here in the option, it is given about the radius, about the mass. You know that it is not depending on the mass. It is not depending on the radius. It is depending only upon ICM, okay, inertia above the center of mass. So for this, you directly you can see when you are putting the value for sphere and the cylinder, you got the value to be what? Greater for the sphere. So the sphere will reach the bottom faster. Okay, so the correct option is option A. Okay, now let's see question number 7. Here it is said a particle of mass m is subject to the potential v is equals to kx squared plus y squared. Here x, y are the Cartesian coordinate of the particle and k is a constant. So which one of the following quantities is a constant of motion? So potential is given to you. What we do, we used to write the Lagrangian, right? And the coordinate which is not available or it is missing in the Lagrangian, okay, corresponding to that particular coordinate, the corresponding momentum will be also what? Constant of motion, right? That is how we have seen about the cyclic coordinates and all these things. In that we have seen about this constant. If you are having any problem, then you can go and watch the classical mechanics lectures. There I have discussed these things. All right. So that way you used to do. So first of all, we will write the Lagrangian. Lagrangian is what? Lagrangian, it is the sum of what? Kinetic energy and the potential energy, right? So for kinetic term, you will write half m x dot k square plus y dot square minus, this is k x square plus y square. This is the kinetic energy term. This is the potential energy term. All right. This is what you are doing. Now this is in the Cartesian form. We will write in the cylindrical form to make it more easier. So it will be half m x dot square plus y dot square. You can directly write it's in two dimensions. So what you will write it to be r dot square plus r square phi square, right? And minus k In cylindrical, it will be in two dimensions, so it is directly what? R square. Okay, so if you see here in this term, in the Lagrangian, what term is missing? This phi is missing, right? This phi, because you're having only R here, no phi. So what do you write? Phi is missing, that means phi is corresponding to what? P phi. Okay, or you can say LZ. Yes or no? So P phi is a constant of motion. This is what you can say. All right. So we know angular momentum L is equal to what? R cross P. This is what you can write. So I cap, if you do J cap and K cap. Okay. So this is X, Y, Z. Okay. For the R. And this is what? PX, PY, PZ. Now corresponding to K cap, what you will get? That is what? LZ. Yes or no? So corresponding to K cap, you will get what? You will get X, P, Y minus Y, P, X. Right? This is what you will get. X, P, Y minus Y, P, X. Clear? So if you see here, from the options, which one will be the correct option? It is what? X, Y dot, right? Minus Y, X dot. Because you see here, why it is Y dot, that also I am telling you. Because we know what? Y dot is equals to what? P, Y by M. Yes or no? X dot is equals to what? P, X by M. Right? From here you can write. Okay? This is what? X, Y dot minus Y, X dot. So the correct option is option B. Clear? So this is very easy. You can just do it. Just questions are not really tough. They are quite, in the language you can say they are quite complicated. All right? So here, the six faces of a cube are painted blue, violet, green, yellow, red, and orange. If the cube is rolled four times, what is the probability that green face appears exactly three times? So it is said six faces of cube are there. They are painted into six different colors. Okay, cube is rolled four times. Okay, and you are asked that how many times there is probability that you will get the green face exactly three times. So we know probability for any color to come. We know probability is what? Number of favorable outcomes divided by number of total outcomes. Okay. So probability is what? Number of favorable outcome for any color, if you see, it is 1, and total outcome is what? 6. Because there are 6 faces. Yes or no? And if you see about the failure, if you see, probability is equals to 1. So probability of failure is what? 1 minus 1 by 6. That is equals to what? 5 by 6. This is the probability for any color for its success. This is for the failure. Right. Now you are asked about the green color. Okay. So if you see here, you are having 4 times the dice will roll and you need 3 times green, right? You need 3 times red. It is not compulsory that in the first time you will get green, or in the second time, in the third time or fourth time. But you need, in total, you need 3 times, right? So you might get, in the first time, you might get some other color, and rest you will get all the same one. It might happen that in the first time you are getting the same, again you may not get the same, something else, again you are getting the same. It might happen in the first and second time you're not having the same. You're having the same. In the third one, also you're having the same. In the last one, you're not having. Okay? Or it can happen in this outcome, you're not having rest, all other you're having. Different outcomes, I'm saying, in 4 times. Okay? So, because you need only exactly the 3 times. Okay? So, finally, the probability that green face will appear exactly 3 times, it will be equals to what? It will be equals to what? The number of events or the number of times that you are having into with what? The success timing is what? 3 times you might get success, might be how many times? 3 times, right? Failure chance is 1. So 5 by 6. So from here when you will do? Okay, this is the failure, this is the success. And success chances out of 4, you need only 3. Right, so 3 times we are writing, 1 I am considering it to be failure. This is how we find the probability. And from here, when you will do, it is what? 2 twos are, 2 threes are, right? Again, 2 threes are. So if you will do, it is what? 9 into with 36. So you will get 5 divided by, when you will multiply, you will get 3 to 4. So the correct option is option C. Clear? So that's how you can calculate. So in this question, in this video, we have solved 8 questions. In the later videos, we will solve some more questions. So that's all in this video. Thank you so much. Have a good day.